we continue multiplying to multiply matrices and to learn about the properties of multiplication. We will start with 9c. This is 9b and 9c. Do I have a reason for starting with 9c? Yes, and it would be obvious shortly. So the first thing that you want to do is find the dimensions. 1, 2, 3 rows, 1, 2 columns. So the matrix on the left is 3 by 2. And then 1, 2, 3 rows. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. So we're trying to multiply a 3 by 2 by a 3 by 4 as well. Always check the dimensions. Uh-oh, we've got a problem. The problem is that the number of columns does not match the number of rows. And so, we start right there. There is no A and B cannot be multiplied. If you're not quite sure why, let's say that I wanted to find the element in the first row, first column. The person that can tell me what the problem is, if I try to find C11, will get an extra credit point. If you're trying to use your calculator, which I promised that I would show you how to use, but I forgot at home. If you're trying to use your calculator to multiply the two matrices, when you try to find the product, it will say, error, dimensions mismatch. So again, extra credit question. What is wrong? Why is it that we cannot multiply the two matrices? Please take a look at the row that I circled, the column that I circled, and then give me an answer in a complete sentence. The first student to get the answer will get the extra credit point. Okay, 9c is done. Next, 9b, as always, let's find dimensions. The first matrix, 1, 2, 3 rows, 1, 2, 3 columns, 3 by 3. The second matrix, 1, 2, 3 rows, 1 column. Let me erase the example from 9c so you can clearly see. What can you see? You can see, you can observe that the middle dimensions once more match. Because the middle dimensions match, it means that the product exists and we can find it. Erase the middle dimensions. And your C, matrix C, is going to be a 3 by 1 matrix. So 3 rows, but only 1 column. Let's find those entries. To find C11, we're going to take the first row. There's nothing else to multiply by other than the lonely column in the entire matrix, or only column in the entire matrix. Let's find it. So, first times first, 6 times 1, second times second, plus 3 times 3. And third entry times the third entry, so plus 0 times negative 3, 6 plus 4 plus 0 is 10. Okay, we have a 10. Order them using the first row, we move on to the second row, same idea. We're going to use the second row and the first column. And so, first times first, plus, now the product of the middle entries, negative 1 times 2, and now the product of the last entries, 2 times negative 3, 3 plus negative 2 plus negative 6, negative 5. Finally, we're going to find the entry in the third row, first column, C, 3, 1. So we're going to use third row from the matrix on the right, the only column from the matrix on the left. And again, the product of the first entries, 1 times 1 plus middle entries, 4 times 2 plus 6 times negative 3. Find their sum, 1 plus 8 plus negative 18. This is 9 plus negative 18, negative 9. And for the number example 9, we did 9A, 9B, 9C. There's no more to it.